In the late 1700s, American revolutions were galvanized by one simple concept: no taxation without representation. To this day, these two concepts make up the most meaningful interaction citizens have with their government. With the city of Martinsville pursuing reversion, it begs two questions. What is going to happen with taxes, and how will Martinsville be represented? Let's begin with the first question. Currently, the residents of Martinsville pay taxes to the city, the state, and the federal government. This will no longer be the case upon reversion. Town residents will be required to pay taxes to the town, the county, the state, and the federal government. From their filing so far, the city has indicated that they intend to adjust their tax rates to make the overall financial impact on residents the same post-reversion as it is now. As we can see from this chart presented by the city, the tax rates in the town and county after reversion equate to the same number that the city has now. Here's how City Mayor Kathy Lawson explains it.
Over a period of time, and I'm thinking 2, maybe 3 years at the most, the town will be able to lower the town portion of the tax because we will not need as much revenue to sustain the services that we provide. Because those services have now been combined with those in Henry County. Initially, you know, we were given advice by the town of South Boston not to immediately, you know, reduce your taxes too low. But what we are, our plan and our goal is we will have a town tax, when you combine it with the county tax, that will be equal to what you currently pay to the city.
While Mayor Lawson says the town tax rates could potentially decrease in the future, there is one main problem with this analysis. It does not portray the overall financial impact on the resident, since county taxes could also increase. During the most recent planning session, there was some potential that the Henry County Board of Supervisors would have to increase taxes to keep up with the rising cost of operations for education and the new adult detention center. If this trend continues, that means the county will have to consider raising taxes to cover these items on top of the expected 10 cents to account for reversion. As noted previously, town residents will also be county residents. This means any tax increase in the county will also be felt by the town of Martinsville. So even if the town were to manage to decrease their taxes in the future, it doesn't guarantee that residents will pay lower taxes overall. Plus, even if the town were able to lower its taxes enough to keep current rate steady, residents will still need to travel farther for certain services and contend with longer wait times in the county due to the increased number of people being served. I suppose town residents could always vote in representatives that promise to lower taxes, but then we run into another problem. And that brings us to our second question. How will Martinsville be represented? Since Virginia treats independent cities as equivalent to counties, cities can have their own governing body and constitutional officers, such as the sheriff, commonwealth attorney, clerk of court, treasurer, and commissioner of revenue. We'll get to the governing body in a second, but first, let's concentrate on constitutional officers. Constitutional officers can play an important role in shaping the daily lives of residents. The commissioner of revenue is responsible for determining the value of your taxable property. This includes determining how much you pay in taxes for your business license, for your vehicles, and even your house. On the flip side, the treasurer is responsible for actually collecting those taxes. The other three constitutional officers, the sheriff, the commonwealth attorney, and the clerk of court, can all influence your experience with the criminal justice system. For example, if justice and policing is an important issue to you, then these officers can have a tremendous sway over that issue. The sheriff's office is responsible for running the jail. The commonwealth's attorney is responsible for determining whether or not to prosecute the individual, and the clerk of court is responsible for preparing court orders and jury lists. Upon reversion, Martinsville will no longer be able to elect their own constitutional officers. Instead, they will vote for the officers in the county. This will equate to a dramatic shift in representation for Martinsville, which has a minority-majority population. To simplify, let's look at how much sway African-American voters have now versus when combined with the population of Henry County. According to the latest census, Martinsville has a population of about 13,485 people. Of that number, about 47% are white. This equates to approximately 6,338 people. About 46% of Martinsville is African American, which is nearly 6,203 people. In Henry County, the total population is about 50,948. Approximately 74.4% is white, which equals about 37,905 people. Only about 22.6% of Henry County is African American, or about 11,514 people. So let's combine those numbers and see what sway African American voters will have when combined with the county. The total combined population would be 64,433. When we add the raw numbers from earlier, we get a combined population in Henry County with 44,243 people who identify as white and 17,717 who identify as African American. When we divide those numbers by the total population, we get an electorate that is 27.4% African American and 68.7% white. African Americans as a potential voting bloc will see their chances of electing a constitutional officer of their choosing drop from 46% to 27.4% after reversion. But that's not all. Citizens also vote for their governing bodies, who make decisions about local ordinances and, most importantly, tax rates. City Council is made up of 5 members who are voted in at large. This means city voters vote for every representative they have. The Board of Supervisors is made up of 6 members who are elected only by the residents of their respective magisterial districts. After reversion, Martinsville will still have a 5-member town council and will also gain representation on the Board of Supervisors. But how much? As City Attorney Eric Monday alludes to in the October 26, 2021 meeting minutes of City Council, Martinsville is likely only guaranteed 1 seat on the Board of Supervisors after reversion. This is because of the concept of one man, one vote, which ensures fair representation. Currently, Henry County is divided in 6 districts with approximately 8,491 people in each district. Since Martinsville has a population of a little over 13,000, then it would be unfair to grant the town more than 1 representative on the Board of Supervisors. So what happens when the governing bodies go to make decisions about tax policy? Remember, Martinsville residents will be paying 2 tax bills after reversion, 1 for the town and 1 for the county. While Martinsville will still have complete control over representatives making decisions over town taxes, they will likely only have 1 representative out of 7 on county taxes, which will be the larger bill. While the city contends that it should have at least 1 seat on the Board of Supervisors, it should be noted that Virginia Code grants the governing body of the county the sole authority to make that decision. This means only the Board of Supervisors will determine whether or not to grant Martinsville a seat on its body. Through a process known as redistricting, it is entirely possible that the Board of Supervisors could draw lines that encompass the city into the already existing districts. This would mean Martinsville, as a town, would not have any special say on county taxes. At the end of the day, Martinsville voters will have to make the decision of what is best for them when it comes to reversion. And much like the American Revolutionists, one question is clear: does the taxation equal the representation?